Never thought I'd be ecstatic at having the walls painted in blood, but seeing as it's not mine, I'd say this calls for a celebration. This ought to square our debt. One hefty payment for a highly valued service rendered. But, I admit, I do wonder why Nioka has brought you to me. Allow me to pose my question in another manner. Why, in the nebula, are you here? Ah yes, our little chat on the intercom. You're looking for the premier broker for all of Monarch. Which you knew was me, clearly. Phineas must have sent you. He's the only one insane enough to send someone to Monarch to rush me. I knew it was only a matter of time before he came a-knocking. Look, I might be late, but I fulfill my contracts, always.
Oh, you do, do you? I have lost track of the number of beers you owe me for chasing Raptodons off your stoop.
Are you fibbing? Be honest.
I take offense to that. Look, okay. Just, it might take me a while this time. I am awaiting but a single incoming transmission containing the information we desire. But MSI and the Iconoclast are clogging the airwaves from Stellar Bay and Amber Heights. In their war against each other, they're scrambling each other's outgoing transmissions. The bandwidth! There's too much blasted background noise. Nothing gets through but their local broadcasts. Which, of course, has inadvertently affected the incoming port and my livelihood. No, they're jamming the limited frequencies we have at our disposal. Nothing extraplanetary can get in or out until the frequency pollution thins out. The safest bet is to convince Graham and Sanjar to stop transmitting on their end. You do that, I'll be here, waiting on the receiving end. Luck be with you. I have a feeling you'll be needing a pinch of it, plus a vat of patience. Oh, great. I love doing pro bono work for friends.
Aw, you called us friends. I'd normally entertain your self-aggrandizing delusions, but this time it's important.
Important to you is not the same as important to me. Although I do recognize that you may have earned some goodwill during your months laboring for me. Tug on my heartstrings, why don't you? Look, I'll do what I can, all right?
Rebecca Hodges and Anders Wadsworth. They took a UDL contract back when Monarch went to shit, and I need to find them. I believe them to be on Terra, too.
If UDL hired two hunters back then, it would have been for creature clearing purposes, round one of their Spacer's Choice outposts. These are the coordinates for the outpost under the last UDL contract. Now scram. And, good luck. Sure. You know where to find me if you need me.
Alright, alright, alright. What they gonna learn today?
daughter is a dead or dying one. Slick work in there.
I am a dirty, autonomous, digital astrogator, Sam. I haven't cleaned my internals in ages. Can you hardly process the sheer quantity of dust buildup in there? Tell me you've seen worse. We are now in orbit above Edgewater, Captain. My compliments to...
Excuse me.
so, love. A clean cargo hold.
The whole world from here.
Thank you. done here.
I'd wager this is the outpost.
Rebecca! Anders! Come on out!
Take a gander. The door's busted.
Huh. Rebecca taught me this once. You can jerry-rig these old locks so as they don't open anymore. But we've only ever done that if we're in a real bind. Here, I'll fix it. Oh, no. Oh, no. What did you do?
Oh, no, God. I'm so sorry.
They were...
That bitch! They were all set to abandon us! What would Clara say, huh? Every day she'd ask if we heard from you. And she'd have forgiven you! The kid had a soul that made the sulfur smell like roses! Hard to leave your medallions to rot with you, but... Clara would want to be buried with her sister.
At least I know. Ought to have learned by now that getting one's hopes up tends to open them to being dashed across the stars. I hate to say this, but... Clara died thinking her sister was still fighting to get back home. I think... I'm glad. If she were still alive now, it'd break her to know the truth. Yeah, maybe. I'm used to disappointment. She was still so naive as to let it hurt her every time it happened. Only thing left is to take these medallions home, which means eat the mana queen out of our old base. The most pissed off I've ever seen a queen was when a foreign species was on her soil. I'd wager the stench of a primal might do the trick. I'd be boring. Half the fun in exploring is the fact that you're on an unknown trail. Never had the pleasure of hunting primals, but I hear they're all over Scylla. Let's tear a few apart, shall we? I'm sure they've got pheromones. Everything does.
So easy when you can fast travel pretty much anywhere.
Welcome aboard, Captain. Destination reached. Scylla.
Hey, you got a minute? Hey, boss. Got a hypothetical for you? You got a friend, see? Somebody you knew when you were growing up. You were close. Then, one day, they up and vanished. 5 years go by, they send you a message out of the aether. What's going through your head? You got the wrong idea, boss. It ain't like that. Guy by the name of Clyde Harlow. He was an old friend of mine. Honestly, he was probably my first and longest friend. I just heard from him. Says he wants to talk to me. Says it's urgent. Figured I should let you know, seeing as we're on Scylla and all. Clyde's got a base on the other side of this rock. I appreciate this, boss. I know you're going out of your way for me.
We'll be here, Captain. Or will we? Haha.
What's on your mind? Yeah, sure thing. Ask away. Clyde was my first friend, but he was also my mentor. Taught me how to think, how to question, how to disobey. I figured the board got him in the end. Some guys with black uniforms snatching him off the street in the middle of the night or something. Yeah, I was just a lonely orphan kid getting my knuckles dirty. Clyde? I want to say he saw some potential in me. Like as not, he just took pity on me. So he took me in. Gave me a place to live. Gave me something to believe in. That's what I don't know. The message was light on details. No explanations, as usual. Clyde. He was a blustery old cuss. Carried on about violent revolution and seizing the means of production. Clyde wasn't an idiot. He kept his head down, worked hard, did as he was told. You're not gonna catch him standing on a soapbox decrying the tyranny of the board. But when the Mardets had their backs turned, oh yeah, he carried on about starting a revolution. Said he was gonna do something good.
Then I do not keep it. I do not have any lead. It's a garbage. It's all the garbage.
Felix, you need some better armor, buddy. Thank you.
go!
Repeating getting beat up by primals, you no longer function well when they attack you or your companions. Phobic. No, I'm not taking any of those phobic perks. I can't do those. Those are... No.
I recognize this. I'm dead set on screwing this place up, too.
Wonder what it'd take to knock this over.
Thank you. Salutations. This unit's primary function is excavator. Owner, Hephaestus Mining Corporation. Other functions include dialogue, limited current active commands, excavation. That is all. Negative. The presence or absence of human operators does not impact this unit's assigned directive. This unit achieves perfection by fulfilling its directive.
This unit sounds like my old foreman.
You know, it's a crying shame that auto mechanicals can't get drunk or laid. This thing needs both.
This unit has now exhausted its available library of opinions about excavation. This unit is removing rock matter in search of minerals, metals, and other forms of matter designated valuable. Brevity identified. Affirmative. This unit could discuss excavation at greater length, but does not wish to strain its daily charge. Thank you for your consumer loyalty, Junior Excavator. This unit will store this exchange in its memory banks, always.
Like some sort of habitation.
trophy again. Let's see what that one is. 10,000 bits worth of items.
That queen ain't gonna go down easy. I can't wait. What's up? Outstanding. These ought to be enough. Let's get back to Monarch. There's an old base I used to call home. I can get us in the door, but we'll have to shoot our way through the Queen's brood to get to the center. We'll set the bait there. Password to the door is Charon. Fucking right we are. I hear you're into Graham's philosophist hogwash, Felix.
Yeah, if by philosophist hogwash you mean the virtues of enlightened anarchy.
The virtues of enlightened anarchy.
Organization separates us from the animals. You ever seen a Rap-Lay plumbing? You see sprats running around building roads? Maybe the folks we have at the top ain't exactly leadership material, but if we tore the whole thing down, we'd be kings and queens of a wasteland.
Correction? Kings and queens of an awesome wasteland.
I'll take toilets over freedom any day of the week.
Shit in the woods and be told what the fuck to do.
Some crew members are causing a disturbance on the ship.
Hey, you. Looking for something?
Where do you think you're going?
Yeah. The captain said we might be getting a new recruit. That you, then?
Sounds like Clyde's jumping to conclusions, but yeah. I'm Felix.
You're on a first-name basis with Captain Harlow, huh? All right. Go on through. Got my sights on you.
What do I want to do today?
Hey there, Hullhead. Clawed your way out of the Groundbreaker at long last?
Uh-huh. Oh, sorry, were you expecting me to say something? Maybe a long time no see, or a you've aged, old man?
So, you took Felix under your wing. Kept him busy. Good. Kid always needed a place to belong.
He kicks things what need kicking, and we look the other way when he starts talking anti-corporate. It's a good arrangement.
Hear that, Clyde? I've been making something out of myself.
So long as you haven't been... No end of stories to tell of your exploits together. I look forward to catching up with the boy. I'm working on something. Something big. Something the likes of which Halcyon has never seen. And I want Felix to be a part of my initiative. I'm fulfilling a promise I made to the boy. That one day, he and I would change the colony together. That day has finally arrived.
Easy there, Clyde. No one said nothing about throwing in with you. In case you didn't notice, I'm pretty happy where I am.
I'm not asking you to walk away from your captain, Felix. But neither should you allow yourself to be controlled by fear. Change is not to be feared. I brought you here because I want to know where Felix's loyalties lie. When the day of our revolution comes, I want to know that I can rely on him.
That's awesome. Oh my god.
Everyone in my crew proves their loyalty. No exceptions. Not even Felix. I want you to deal with a traitor for me. Name's Trask. Kill him. And bring me proof of his death. His ring should do nicely. Ratted us out to the board. He's been an informant. Has been for years. When he realized I was onto him, he and his little cadre mutinied. Killed five of my own and tucked tail. I don't know where he's hiding, but his wife might. Rosanna. Lives on the Groundbreaker, last I checked. Rosanna knows my crew by name and face, but you're a stranger to her. She'll talk to you.
You think so? Maybe we should have a word with Trask. Get his side of the story first.
You'd be wasting your breath bandying words with that traitor. But if it makes you feel better, by all means. Remember, I want proof. Bring me his ring. I don't care if the hand's still attached. Here, my token. Think of this as my personal signature. Anyone who knows me by my works will know me by this token.
Some crew members are...
You're adjusting... Before you pull. You're anticipating it. You...
Of course I'm anticipating it. What if I shoot a friend on accident?
We are now in orbit above Stellar Bay, Captain. No blockade is a match for my piloting skills.
Stellar Bay. Taking the sights, the sounds. Wait, what's that smell?
You'll get used to it. Give it 10 or 15 years.
with us.
Find you.
Returning fire.
Go on, Felix.
To shred.
That's the last of him.
Here we go. I haven't set foot in here since... Well... I'm ready. Yeah. Right? Yeah. Here we go.
up, jackass!
Well, this is the spot. You know, I thought I'd be angry. I thought I'd storm in here in a rage and exterminate all these bugs and everything would be all right in the end. But I ain't. I'm mostly just empty. A little sad, maybe. The first night Hayes and I spent in here, we knew it was home. It's safe. It's got a nice chill to it. But mostly, it doesn't stink of sulfur. Monarch folks often joke about it. Not because of the smell or the grittiness it leaves in your throat. Not because of the headaches or the coughing. It's because there's no escaping it. It's life here, and there ain't anything you can do about it. But here, somehow the sulfur never made it. The nights we spent in here felt like vacations. So we started building. We hauled in steel, hired sublight folk to help. That's how we met Anders and Opal. They stuck around after our contract was up. Opal liked camping. Anders liked chasing her tail. Four of us for a while, scraping together what bits we could to build our home. Then came Rebecca, a sawbones out of the Cascadia survivors, who took a kindness to Hayes. And Clara, her little sister. I'll admit I wasn't keen on taking her on at first. But for a teenager, she was surprisingly capable. Believe me, I had my complaints. She had a head for numbers, helped us trade hides for food and materials, negotiated contracts, turned out to be mighty useful. Clara, Hayes, Anders, Rebecca, Opal, and me. Six folks, one name. One family. Charon. Despite Monarch trying to kill us day in and day out, we managed to belong.
Pick up, boss!
Hey, boss, watch this!
wish these were more auspicious circumstances, but at least we're all here.
Anything for a friend.
This.
I finished the campaign. The companion's quest line. Oh, nice. Trophies, everybody. Oh, man.
Bring it. That makes it stupid. By all accounts, we should have left well enough alone, but that also makes it right. Captain, thank you. You mind if we rest a spell before we head out? I'd like to bury Opal and Clara proper before I lay everyone's medallions to rest. What? Why? Them's painful memories, Captain. Huh. That ain't a bad point. All right, Captain. Thanks. stalking, and we're stalking.
Here we go! That's one down! You're going down!
To shreds, you say?
That was fun. Good thing I got my hiking boots on. They're actually the same as my ass-kicking boots. I can't afford another pair.
Saved game. And it is time.